So those of you who are, you know, legacy customers and then joined the annual service plan, Texturino is one of the plugins that's been around for a little while, and we have done some updates on it over the last couple of years. But generally, it's a live texture application tool that also has a texture manager. Now, today, I'm not going to go through the whole texture manager side. If you go on Astute Graphics YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/AstuteGraphics, we've got a whole playlist for Texturino that shows you all the settings, how to use the manager and everything. But one of the things I've been working on recently is I've been doing book covers, and one of the book covers I actually did was ironically for Photoshop, and I had to create some stickers for it that looked like they were on a toolbox. And so what I did was I actually used Illustrator and InDesign to make a book cover for Photoshop. But one of the things that was really cool was we did a partnership with Retro Supply. And we have, anyone on the annual service plan can get a bunch of free downloads from us. And one of the packs was from Retro Supply. And there was one particular texture in there that was absolutely perfect for the job. And I thought about how I used it for the book, and I just wanted to show today that why I think it's so cool and how you can use it in Illustrator to create some really cool artwork without having to keep coming out and going over to Photoshop to get those final effects at the end. So what I did was I went on good old Adobe stock, because we've got an account, and I downloaded some graphics here. And what I was thinking was, like an old rock guitar, you know, we all love music, and I was just thinking of the kind of things where you'd seen worn out stickers where like your hands rubbing across it. So the videos on YouTube that we've got, I actually recorded this tutorial, and it was done on a toolbox and an old suitcase. And it's the same kind of thing here. So I've got these stickers, or what I'd like to think are going to be the stickers on my artwork. And the one I'm going to pick is this one. This is my favorite logo in the world. And one of the best bands in the world, Rolling Stones. So I'm going to take this tongue logo, and I'm going to put it on a guitar, and I'm going to make it look absolutely battered and worn. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to copy it from here and paste it into my artwork, because I could do everything here, but I want to see what's happening while I'm working on it. So I'm just going to do a Command C on this. I'm going to come over to my guitar, and I'm going to do Command V. It's going to be really tiny, so I'm just going to resize that, holding the shift key down to get constraint, and I'm just going to kick it round a little bit as well, just to let's just spin it round there. And I'm deliberately going to put it here. You can see where the guitar has been worn the most, so let's just bring that over there, just on that edge. Now, one quick tip, that this was something Nick told me about when I was doing the previous tutorials, is when you start doing things like Texturino, you start to get some settings and annotations that you want to be able to see what's going on. So one of the first things to do is come up here and go to hide edges. Now, before I do that, I'll show you why. So let's come over to the texture panel. Now, as I said, we've got a bunch of textures that you can download if you've got an annual service plan account, and it's called the Retro Supply Texture Snack Pack. So from the texture panel, and obviously that's window, Texturino to open it up, just come down, it's down here, and then you've got three panels. We're using Texturino to start with. And you can go straight to the category that you've got. So I've already got these downloaded. You can download them from anywhere. You don't just have to have the ones from us. And I'm going to go to the, where are we now? It's Old Bandage Tin, I believe. Let's just check. Yeah, Old Bandage, that's the one. Okay, so to apply a texture, I go in and I pick the one that I want. I can see here roughly what it looks like. It gives me some information on the size. It's a non-repeating pattern. And all I need to do to add this texture to this graphic is click on this plus sign. But you can see here already, because it knows I'm going to use Texturino, you can see all these dots, these points around the artwork. I don't want to see them. So this is where hide edges comes into play. I just want to see the artwork. So my artwork is selected. Let's just click on it to be sure. There's the bounding box. I'm going to come over to Texturino, and all I have to do is click plus. And what that's going to do is apply this texture to this sticker, nothing else, just this group of artwork here. Now I've got some annotations, which means I can start to put add some control to this. So the first thing I'm going to do is look at the scale. Now at the moment, you can only see the texture within the artwork. So as I start to pull the scale in, you can see the bounding box of the original size of that actual texture. So I'm just going to bring it in nice and close there. And the reason I've done that is because I know there's a big, nice, big, dark bit of texture at the top. I'm not going to try. There we go, around here. And this is where I want that to be. So because I've scaled it in now, the other thing I can also do is rotate the texture just by using the bounding box, or I can use the annotation here. And I want to get this rough part right on this faded part here. So I can also click and drag and bring that in. Let's just scale that up a little bit more. And I just want to get it over this part here, this really warm bit. Now, you're looking at it thinking, yep, okay, it's got a nice texture on it, but it doesn't really look like it's properly worn. And that's where the next bit comes in, which I think is a fantastic part of Texturino. And I could be right in saying, Nick could correct me, I think this blend mode that I'm going to show you wasn't in the original version. We added it later, and it's called Knockout. And what it does, you've got all these other ones here. If you use Photoshop, you'll be familiar with blend modes. They're also already in Illustrator in the transparency panel. But we're going to come down to Knockout here. And what that's going to do is it's going to punch right through that graphic through to the guitar on the back. And just to prove it, we'll just click away. So we've applied the texture now. I'm happy with everything. Just going to click on here. So we've just got the artwork. And you'll see now, as I pull the artwork round, you see that white, you can see the blue coming through now. In fact, if I go really drastic, bring it over here, you can see that coming through. So what that's done is it's punched through the artwork, but actually it's left it as a live piece of artwork. So if I wanted to, I can come up to the appearance. I can see I've got Texturino applied there. If I just click on it, I get the annotations back. I can go ahead if I want. I can look at that and think, all right, I like that one. I wonder what another one looks like. So we can come over here. Let's just pick a really random one. Let's go static lines. And all I need to do is pick a new texture and come up to this button here. And what that will do is it will replace the current texture with the selected texture, but it will keep the settings as well. So that one's not as good. I don't think that's got the same kind of effect. So I do like that original, the old bandage tin. That's my favorite one. So I'm going to go back to that. And that gives you that really nice live kind of worn out effect. So the other thing you can do just to prove that it is live artwork is if I just click on these lips here and come up here and change that to pink. I didn't make a very good job of that because I didn't select the lips, but it's still live, so you can still adjust it. So let's just Command-Z and come out of that. There we go. Oh, went too fast. Hold on. There we go. We go back. So that's Texturino. That's just applied the texture to that sticker. Let's just zoom out to show you what that looks like. I was going to apply another texture to it, but it's a bit overkill. But you can actually apply more than one texture. And you can see straight away that looks more realistic on a guitar than if I just copied and pasted it and tried to use a blend mode, which wouldn't have worked as well. But one of the things about with rock and roll, if you're a guitarist or a musician, you'll also know that you sometimes get a little bit more wear than just that. So the second bit of artwork I wanted to show you with Texturino was guitar pick, or plectrum as we call them here, and again from the same artwork here, I just picked this tiger and put the tiger icon on these three. I'm just going to use this one for now. So again, I want to give it that kind of knocked through effect. So I'm come over to Texturino. I'm going to apply the same texture because, you know, it's my favorite one, I like it. Let's just bring that scale down, and we've got that. Oh, there we go. We know that warm bit is at the top. But this time, if you hold a plectrum, your fingers tend to be down this bottom half. This is where all the wear comes in. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to flip that round. I don't need to hold the shift key. It doesn't really matter. But I want this texture to be pushing through down here at the bottom near the tiger's mouth. So let's just get that into position there. And again, we can go ahead and use knockout. And that just pushes through the image. Let's just come away from that so we can see what we're doing. So what that's done is it's worn it away through to the guitar pick. But if anybody knows who's got a guitar pick, you don't always get that kind of uniform wear. You actually get more of this worn away. So we've got another couple of parts of Texturino that you can use. One's texture brush and one's the opacity brush, and that's the one I'm going to use. So with my tiger face picked, I'm just going to come over to the opacity brush, and you'll see here the cursor's changed. So I've got this brush here that I can resize just by scaling that or using the left and right brackets. I've got hardness, softness, opacity and noise. Now I've been playing with this, so I've kind of got a setting that I want. But what I wanted to do was actually paint away some of the bottom of the tiger's face just to give it that extra little worn look. So all I need to do is get my size. I'm going to come over to the artwork. I'm going to make sure that the tiger is selected. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start painting away some of the bottom of his face. It's actually a bit harsh. So let's just Command Z there. Let's make the brush a little bit larger. And then we'll just kind of paint away the bottom around here. And you can see now some of that texture stays in the artwork, but we can actually start to take away some of the art off the plectrum and make it look a little bit more worn. But it's live. We've got all these effects in the appearance panel. We can come back in, we can adjust this. I love Texturino. I've just been using this constantly, making stickers and putting things on toolboxes. But the really cool thing is the fact that you don't just have to use textures that we've supplied. Like I said, you can go and create your own. You can go and download them from Adobe Stock. You can get them from any resource site like Design Cuts, Retro Supply. And you just use the texture manager to bring them in. And then you can start playing around with them and then show your friends what you've done. And I actually showed someone one of these, a toolbox. I said it was a photograph of a toolbox. And they actually believed that the stickers were worn on it, and it wasn't in actual fact a photograph of the toolbox. And then when you show them what you've done, they're like, oh, I would have done that in Photoshop. Well, you don't have to. You can do it in Illustrator. So that was a quick kind of run through of how to do something cool with Texturino. If you haven't tried it yet, I suggest you go and get it and make sure it's installed and start playing around. But That's me done today. Again, there's some videos for this already on our YouTube channel. So if you want to see this demonstration, but a little bit deeper, I suggest you go to YouTube and watch that. But for now, I'm going to pass back to Nick.